The thesaurus is not static or set in stone. As I mentioned earlier, over the years, the thesaurus has changed, with revisions and updates released periodically throughout its history. In this next section, I will talk about why and how we maintain the ERIC Thesaurus. First, we will review the reasons it is important to update the thesaurus. Next, we will go through ERIC's thesaurus update process. Finally, we will take a sneak peek at the upcoming 2015 thesaurus update. Why update the thesaurus? There are three main reasons why it is important to regularly update the ERIC Thesaurus: usability, currency, and relevancy. The first reason is to ensure the usability of the thesaurus, to make sure you can find the terms you want so you can find the content you want. Additions to the thesaurus, whether they are synonyms or descriptors, enhance access to ERIC content. This is why synonyms are particularly critical additions to the thesaurus. As I mentioned earlier, we can have many different synonyms leading to one descriptor. By adding additional synonyms, we can increase the chances that users will find a descriptor for their topic of interest in the thesaurus. Updating the thesaurus to enhance its usability is critical to preserving ERIC's overall usefulness to its users. Another reason to update the thesaurus is to keep it current. Language is constantly evolving, and the language of education is no exception. The terms used in education research change over time. They may reflect changes in attitudes and interests. Once popular topics may fall by the wayside. Some topics become obsolete as research in the field advances. Keeping the thesaurus current is critical to ensuring that the thesaurus reflects the active vocabulary of education, and that ERIC can help provide access to its content using the most up-to-date terminology. Finally, it is important to update the thesaurus to keep it relevant. New fields of interest and areas of research need to be incorporated. The boom in technology use in education, for instance, has required and continues to require a number of new terms. Education research is also quite interdisciplinary, causing terms in other fields to bleed into the vocabulary of education. A relevant thesaurus ensures that ERIC continues to provide users with easy access to content in emerging topic areas. How does ERIC go about updating the thesaurus? There are three main steps in the process: term identification and selection, proposal development, and proposal review. First, we need to identify terms to be added and terms to be changed. Our primary sources of information are ERIC indexers and users. ERIC indexers see ERIC content every day and note where there are gaps or changes in the vocabulary. ERIC users bring perspectives from research as well as practice and provide subject area expertise. Indexers and users may request new descriptors, new synonyms, and changes to existing terms. Changes to existing terms include adding or revising scope notes, adding or revising relationships, or transitioning terms from synonym to descriptor status, or vice versa. Once we have identified potential additions and changes to the thesaurus, we need to select a group for further development. All indexer and user requests are reviewed, and the final selection is made based on criteria established in the ERIC style guide. For each new term request, we ask, does it qualify as a thesaurus term? Thesaurus terms must be nouns or noun phrases that represent a subject in a field of education. Proper nouns are not usually included, although they may be if they represent a significant concept in education research. Is it useful? Terms added to the ERIC thesaurus must be useful for indexing and retrieval. To determine if a term is useful, we consider: does it duplicate any existing thesaurus terms? Does it exhibit staying power, showing regular usage in the education literature over time? Is it an emerging term that is replacing an older term in the education literature? Is it a synonym of an existing thesaurus term that would aid in retrieval? We also ask, is there literary warrant? Literary warrant means that the term actually appears in ERIC content. The term must appear in the ERIC literature before it can be added to the thesaurus. Terms with a high level of literary warrant, 1,000 hits or more, are considered to be priorities. Is there a need? If we've received multiple requests for the same edition or change, we also consider those requests to be a priority. Although we can't select every request for further development, we never get rid of any requests. All are kept and examined when a thesaurus update is scheduled. Once a term is selected for further review, a proposal for how the term should appear in the thesaurus must be developed. First, research is conducted on the term. Definitions in dictionaries, encyclopedias, and other thesauri and ERIC documents are examined and documented. This helps to establish a working definition of the term that can be used to construct a scope note and clarify relationships to other terms in the thesaurus. The working definition may also help determine if a term requires a scope note to distinguish its use in the field of education from other uses or to differentiate it from another term in the thesaurus. An example of the latter in the thesaurus is the term performance-based assessment, which includes a note to distinguish it from performance tests. Term usage in ERIC is examined to identify any differences in how a term is defined or used within the ERIC literature. This helps determine if more than one term is required to address multiple uses. An example from the thesaurus is the concept of articulation, which has two different definitions in ERIC. Two terms were required to cover both definitions, so two terms were added, each one with an indication of its definition provided in parentheses. The categories and the scope notes for articulation education further distinguish these terms from one another. Examining term usage also helps to determine if a term is not used consistently, indicating that more time may be needed for the concept to solidify before it can be added to the thesaurus. After we complete the research, we use that information to construct the term entry. This includes selecting the final form the term name will take, writing a scope note if necessary, establishing the appropriate relationship, and selecting a category. All of this work is completed by experienced professional taxonomists. We check each other's work, discuss any issues, and must come to a unanimous agreement on all aspects of the term's entry before it can proceed to the next step. Once the taxonomists have completed their work, the proposals are then reviewed by the ERIC indexers and quality assurance staff. They thoroughly review the proposals, checking the research and the proposed term entry. Having two layers of review, as well as multiple reviewers with different expertise, helps ensure that the changes we are making to the thesaurus are accurate, complete, and that they meet the needs of indexers and users. At this stage, some changes to a term entry may be made if there are concerns about the entry as proposed. Once we have resolved any issues and achieved a majority of approvals for a proposal, it is then considered ready for official inclusion into the thesaurus. The work to update the thesaurus began in February, starting with the term identification and selection process. As part of that first step, we invited the user community to provide input into the update by contributing their suggestions for new terms and changes to existing terms. A number of those suggestions were selected for further development and are anticipated to be part of the completed update. The proposal development stage was completed in June. Now we are in the proposal review stage. A final list of recommended additions and changes to the thesaurus will be sent to the department later this month. The thesaurus update is slated for release to the website later this year. The 2015 update will include nearly 20 new descriptors. Proposed new descriptors include Common Core State Standards, low-income students, and value-added models. The update will also contain nearly 30 new synonyms. Some of these are being entered as synonyms for new descriptors. Some are being added as synonyms for existing descriptors. Proposed new synonyms include differentiation, which is a new synonym of individualized instruction, and MOOCs, an abbreviation of massive open online courses, which will be a synonym for online courses. Finally, there will be approximately 17 changes made to existing terms. One of the most important changes we are making is to switch from using the term mental retardation to the term intellectual disability. We've been tracking the transition in the literature for several years. Intellectual disability was added as a synonym in 2008 to accommodate the growing use of the term and in anticipation of eventually making it the preferred term. Once the update is complete, intellectual disability will be a descriptor and mental retardation will be one of its synonyms. This chart shows the number of ERIC records containing mental retardation or intellectual disability in the title or abstract from 1966 to 2002. As you can see, there was a clear transition from mental retardation as the preferred term to intellectual disability as the preferred term. Now that we've covered the nuts and bolts of the thesaurus, Judy Beck will talk about how the thesaurus is used to enable resource discovery in ERIC.